Welcome all of you on Chemistry Study Channel Chemiluminescence. In this video, we are going to study about chapter number 10, halogen derivatives. First, we'll see the introduction and classification of halogen derivatives. Before going to introduction part, first we'll see how much weightage this unit have in board exam, approximate mass given, without option this unit have 4 mass, with option this unit have 6 mass. What we will study in this unit? First, we'll see the introduction of halogen derivatives. Next, classification of halogen derivatives. Then after this, nomenclature of halogen derivatives. There are two systems by which name of organic compounds are decided. First one is a common name system and the second one is a IUPAC name system. We'll see both of them. After this, we'll see the method of preparation. In this, we will study the different methods by which halogen derivatives are synthesized. After this, we will study the physical and chemical properties of halogen derivatives. That means how physically and chemically halogen derivatives behave. And the last one, we will see the usage and environmental effect of compounds of halogens or halogen derivatives. That means whether it have positive impact on environment or a negative impact on environment. Let's see first what is halogen. Halogen is represented by symbol capital X. In periodic table, group 17 elements are called halogens. We know there are total 18 group in periodic table. Group 18 elements are most stable elements because their outermost shell is completely filled. And these halogens belongs to group 17. That is, they required one electron to complete their outermost shell. Hence, electronic configuration or general electronic configuration of these halogens is NH2NP5, and they are most reactive elements in the periodic table. Do you know which elements are present in group 17? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine are belongs to group 17. There may be one more element, that is artificially synthesized element named NH9 having symbol capital T small s. If you know group 17 elements name and symbols, that is very good. But if you don't know it, I am giving you a short mnemonic to memorize group 17 elements. If you memorize this small sentence, you will able to write a symbol of halogen, and from that symbol you can write the name of the element. The short mnemonic is first class biryani I ate. What you have to do? You have to remember just or memorize this small sentence, that is first class biryani I ate, in which this first is for fluorine because it begins with F. Second, that is class, is for chlorine because it is start with Cl. Biryani, there is a B and R, that's why it is for Br, that is bromine. I itself, it is a symbol of iodine. And AT, that is for astatine. What you have to do? You have to just memorize this small sentence, that is first class biryani I ate. And from this symbol, you can write or you can able to write the symbol or a name of halogen. Next is a what is derivative. The derivatives are compounds that is synthesized from parent compound by replacement of one or more atoms or a group of atoms. Next is the halogen derivative. We just seen what is halogen. It is represented by capital X, and derivatives are the compound which is synthesized from parent compound by replacement atom or a group of atom. So let's see what is halogen derivative. From this equation, we can understand what is halogen derivative. Here you can see this is a methane, which is a parent compound. This is the halogen. And what is the product? A product is CH3X, that is methyl halide. What happened in this reaction? One hydrogen of methane is get replaced by halogen atom. That means it is a derivative which is synthesized from parent compound by replacement of one hydrogen by halogen. That's why we can say it is a halogen derivative. So the definition of halogen derivative is when a hydrogen atom or an atom of aliphatic or aromatic hydrocarbons are replaced by corresponding number of halogen atom or atoms, either chlorine, bromine or iodine, the resulting compound are called halogen derivative. That means what will be the form by replacement of one or more hydrogen of aliphatic or aromatic hydrocarbon is called halogen derivative. Next is a classification of halogen derivatives. Halogen derivatives are classified mainly in two ways. First one is on the basis of hydrocarbon skeleton to which halogen atom is bonded. Means how the hydrocarbon chain is looks like, whether it is a single carbon chain or whether it is a double bonded chain or whether it is a triple bonded chain or whether it contains an aromatic ring. On the basis of that, halogen derivatives are classified as haloalkanes, haloalkenes, haloalkynes and haloarenes. First one is a haloalkane. We know that alkane, that means a compound in which all the carbon-carbon bonds are single. If a halogen atom is bonded to alkane, is called haloalkane. Here you can see that in this it is ethyl halide in which the carbon-carbon is bonded by single bond and to which a halogen atom is bonded. Hence, it is example of haloalkanes. Haloalkene, the similar thing, the compound in which carbon-carbon double bond is present, and if the halogen atom is bonded to alkene, is called haloalkene. Example is this one. Here you can see the carbon-carbon is bonded by double bond, and to double bonded carbon, a halogen atom is attached. Hence, it is example of haloalkene. Next one is a haloalkyne. Alkyne means a compound in which carbon-carbon triple bond is present, and if the halogen atom is bonded to carbon, which is triply bonded, is called haloalkyne. Here it is the example. Here the halogen which is bonded to a carbon which is triply bonded carbon means it is a example of haloalkyne. And from that you can predict or guess what is haloarenes. Arene word is used for aromatic compound. Hence, the halogen atom is bonded to aromatic compound, that means a benzene-like compound, is called haloarene. Example is this one. Here, halogen atom is bonded to a benzene ring. Hence, it is example of haloarene. Next class of halogen derivatives is classified on the basis of number of halogen atoms. That means how many halogen atoms are present in particular group, whether it is a one halogen, two halogen, three halogen or more than that halogen. On the basis of this, it is classified into mono, di, tri and polyhalogen compounds. From the name itself, you can guess how many halogen will be present in particular compound. Let's see one by one. Mono halogen compound. A compound in which only one halogen atom is present is example of mono halogen compound. Here are the examples. Dihalogen compound, a compound in which two halogen atoms are present, are the examples of dihalogen compound. All these three are examples of dihalogen compound. Trihalogen compound, a compound in which three halogen atoms are present. Hence, these two are the examples of trihalogen compound. And a polyhalogen compound, a compound in which more than three halogen atoms are present, are called polyhalogen compounds. Monohalogen compounds are further classified on the basis of position of halogen atom and the type of hybridization of carbon to which halogen is attached. In that, the first one is a alkyl halide or a haloalkane. Alkyl halides are the compound in which halogen atom is bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon atom, that is saturated aliphatic hydrocarbons. It is again further classified into three types, that is primary, secondary or tertiary haloalkanes or alkyl halides, on the basis of substitution state of carbon to which halogen atom is bonded. Let's see one by one what is primary, secondary or tertiary alkyl halide. First one is a primary halide or primary alkyl halide. This one is example of primary alkyl halide. A halogen atom is bonded to primary carbon atom are called primary alkyl halide. And a primary carbon is which carbon? A carbon which is attached to only one other carbon atom. This R group is nothing but the alkyl group in which carbon is present. That is, this carbon is further attached to only one carbon atom. Hence, this green carbon is the primary carbon. And if the halogen atom is bonded to primary carbon atom, that is called primary alkyl halide. The definition is this one. Alkyl halide in which halogen atom is bonded to primary carbon, that means a carbon atom which is attached to only one other carbon atom, are called primary halide, secondary halide, or secondary alkyl halide. This one is the example of secondary halide. When a halogen atom is bonded to secondary carbon atom, are called secondary halide. And the secondary carbon is which carbon? The carbon which is attached to two more carbon atoms is called secondary carbon. Hence, the definition is this one. You can say it as a alkyl halide in which halogen atom is bonded to secondary carbon atom are called secondary halide. From these two, you can guess what will be the tertiary halide. So the tertiary halide, the example is this one. Tertiary halide in which halogen atom is bonded to tertiary carbon atom. And tertiary carbon atom is that carbon which is attached to three other carbon atoms are called tertiary halide. The definition is this one. So what we have to see? First, you have to observe the carbon to which halogen is bonded. If it is a carbon which is further bonded to three other carbon atoms, that is the example of tertiary halide. If the carbon which is bonded to, on which halogen atom is present and which is bonded to two other carbon atoms, is a secondary halide. And if a halogen atom to which is bonded to a carbon which is further bonded to only one carbon atom, is a primary alkyl halide. Next monohalogen compound is a allylic halide. The allylic halide is a halogen atom is bonded to allylic carbon atom. And which carbon is called allylic carbon atom? The carbon which having a hybridization sp3 and which is next to the carbon-carbon double bond is called allylic carbon. And if the halogen atom is bonded to allylic carbon, is called allylic halide. Here you can see in this example, this carbon is a sp3 hybridized. How to recognize whether it is sp3, sp2 or sp? If the carbon is bonded by single bond, it is sp3. If carbon is bonded by double bond, it is sp2. And if carbon is bonded by triple bond, that is sp carbon. So this carbon is bonded by single bond to other carbon atom. Hence, it is a sp3 hybridized carbon atom to which a halogen atom is bonded. And this carbon is next to the double bond. Hence, it is a allyl carbon or allylic carbon. Hence, this is an example of allylic halide. A second example also you can see. The yellow shaded carbon is next to the carbon-carbon double bond and which having a hybridization sp3. And on which halogen atom is present. Hence, this one is an example of allylic halide. And the definition is, in allylic halide, halogen atom is bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon atom next to the carbon-carbon double bond. Another monohalogen compound is a benzylic halide. And these are the examples of benzylic halide. Here you can say that halogen atom is bonded to carbon atom which having hybridization sp3 and which is bonded to an aromatic compound or a benzene ring is called benzylic halide. And this green carbon is called benzylic carbon. So in simple way, you can say that the halogen atom which is bonded to benzylic carbon is called benzylic halide. This one is the definition. Next example or next compound is a vinylic halide. These are the examples of vinylic halide. Here you can see that halogen atom is bonded to a carbon atom which is again bonded by a double bond. So the hybridization of this carbon is sp2. Hence, vinylic halide is a compound in which halogen atom is bonded to vinylic carbon. And the vinylic carbon having a hybridization sp2 which is bonded to double bond. Hence, we can say the definition is that in vinylic halide, halogen atom is bonded to sp2 hybridized carbon atom of aliphatic chain. And vinylic halide is a haloalkene. In another example, here also you can see this is a cyclohexene compound. This yellow shaded carbon having hybridization sp2 because it is a doubly bonded carbon and to which this halogen is bonded. Hence, it is a vinylic halide. Next is a haloalkyne. Halo word is used for halogen and alkyne is used for the carbon-carbon triple bond or a compound in which carbon-carbon triple bond is present. From that you can get a compound in which halogen atom is bonded to triply bonded carbon atom which having a hybridization sp. So this one is example of haloalkyne. When a halogen atom is bonded to sp hybridized carbon atom is haloalkyne. And the next monohalogen compound is a aryl halide or haloaryl. When the halogen atom is directly bonded to aromatic compound or sp2 hybridized carbon of aromatic ring is called aryl halide. Here in example you can see this is the monohalogen derivative of benzene in which halogen is directly bonded to benzene ring is a example of aryl halide, or it is also known as a haloaryl. If you find that this video is useful, then recommend it to your friends and like and share it, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.